This is our review for our intermediate algebra final exam. In this first problem, we're going to use order of operations to evaluate an expression. So remember our order of operations, PEMDAS, so parentheses or grouping symbols, exponents, multiplication or division in order, and then addition or subtraction. So first I'm going to look at this absolute value. That's a grouping symbol. I'm going to do what's inside. So 5 minus 16 is negative 11. The rest remains. Then I'm going to take the absolute value of negative 11, which is positive 11. Now I have addition, subtraction, and multiplication. Multiplication comes first. Now I do addition and subtraction in the order that they come. But here I have 12 minus 12, so I'm going to go ahead and do that first. 0, so my final answer is 11. Here I'm going to evaluate given values for x and y. So what I do is I plug in 2 for x and negative 3 for y. So I have 2 to the 4th over 3 times 2 squared minus negative 3 to the 3rd. 2 to the 4th is 16. 3 times 2 squared is 4, minus negative 3 to the 3rd is negative 27. So I have 16 over 12 plus 27, which gives me 16 over 39. Now I check, 16 divides by 2, 4, and 8. 39 only divides by 3 and 13. Can't reduce this, so that's my final answer. This has an extra subtraction. Okay. This I need to factor completely, and what I have is I have a difference of cubes. Now, our formula for a difference of cubes. And if I had a sum of cubes, okay, but I have a difference of cubes, so I'm going to use this formula here. So first I'm going to take the cube root of 27x to the third. That's 3x, and cube root of 8y to the third is 2y. And how I got that is 27 is 3 times 9, which is 3 times 3. Therefore, 3 is my cube root. And 8 is 2 times 4, which is 2 times 2. So 2 is my cube root. So now I have 3x is basically my a, and 2y is my b. So I do a minus b. A squared is 3x squared, so that's 9x squared plus a times b, so 3 times 2 is 6, and then I get xy, and then y squared is 4y squared, sorry, b squared. So this is completely factored. Here I'm going to find all the values for x being undefined. So in order to find that, I can't have 0 in the denominator, so I need to set this equal to 0. And I can solve this either by factoring, completing the square, or using the quadratic formula. I'm going to factor because factors of 21 that add up to 10 are 3 and 7, and since I need to add up to negative 10, I have x minus 3, x minus 7. So x minus 3 equals 0, x minus 7 equals 0. So here I would have x minus 3, or equals 3, and x equals 7. So my factors of values of x for which x is undefined are 3 and 7. Here I want to simplify. I need a common denominator in order to add these. So first I'm going to factor my two denominators. So I get x plus 1 times x plus 3. because the factors of 3 that add up to 4 are 1 and 3. And then I have x minus 1, x minus 3. Or, sorry, not minus 3. Minus 5. And actually, that was supposed to be a plus. Sorry. Those are both pluses. Now, I look here, I have an x plus 1 in common. So my denominator needs to have that x plus 1. It needs to have an x plus 3 and an x plus 5. Now, in order to turn this into this, I would need to multiply by x plus 5. So, in order to turn this into this, I multiply by x plus 3. Okay. Next, hold on one second, let me pause this. Okay, now that I have a common denominator, I'm going to distribute in my numerator. So I have 3x squared plus 15x plus 2x squared plus 6x, and that's all over x plus 1, x plus 3, x plus 5. And I'm going to collect my like terms, so I get 5x squared plus 21x. Can factor an x out of my numerator. And nothing cancels, so I'm finished. Here I need to simplify. So first, I'm going to switch this division into fraction multiplication. And then I'm going to factor my numerators and denominators. In this numerator, I can factor out a 4. My denominator, factors of 12 that add up to 7. Are 3 and 4. Here, factors of 16 that add up to 8 are 4 and 4. And here I can factor out a 2. Now I'm going to cross cancel. I can cancel these x plus 5s. I can cancel these x plus 4s. And 2 goes into 4 twice. Multiplying, I get 2 times x plus 4 over x plus 3. That's what's left. Here I want to simplify this. So first, I'm going to create a situation where I can actually add these together and have a common denominator. So in order to turn a 1 into having a denominator of x squared, it's going to be x squared over x squared minus 81 over x squared divided by x over x minus 9 over x. So now I can combine those. So I have x squared minus 81 over x squared divided by x minus 9 over x. Now this is division, so I can rewrite this as division. So I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal. I'm going to factor this difference of squares, so that's x plus 9 times x minus 9 over x times x over x minus 9. I'm going to cross cancel. And so I'm left with x plus 9. Okay, here for my division, I'm going to change this into a polynomial long division, or I can use synthetic division. Since my coefficient is a 1, synthetic division might be the easiest way to go. So basically, this is 5x squared plus 3x minus 6 divided by x plus 2. So I put my negative 2. My coefficients are 5, 3, and negative 6. I'm going to bring down my 5. 5 times negative 2 is negative 10. 3 plus negative 10 is negative 7. Negative 7 times negative 2 is positive 14. Negative 6 plus 14 is 8, so my remainder is 8. So my answer is 5x minus 7 plus 8 over x plus 2. Or, depending on how they want you to write it, you can have 5x minus 7 with a remainder of 8. Okay, integers. Integers are not fractions and not decimals. 2 is an integer. Negative 6.8 is not. The square root of 3 can't be simplified without being a non-repeating decimal, so it is not. 12 divided by 4 is 3, so this is an integer. The square root of 16 equals 4, so this is an integer, and 0 is an integer. Simplify. I'm going to distribute in each of these external exponents first. So I'm going to get 3 squared, which is 9, x to the 8th, y squared, times 4 to the negative 3, which is negative 60. Sorry, no, it's not. One over 4 to the third, so 1 over 64. X to the negative 9, y to the negative 12. So this will be 9x to the 8th, y squared. We're not allowed to have negative exponents, so that's 1 over 64 x to the 9th, y to the 12th. If I multiply that, nine and 64 doesn't reduce. We have 8 x's and 9 x's. So these 8 cancel 8 of these, leaving 1. These 2 cancel 2 of these, leaving 10. So I have 9 over 64xy to the 10th. Okay, I have negative 27 64ths to the 2 thirds. This is my root. This is my exponent. So this is essentially negative 27 64ths, that's the cube root squared. The cube root of 27 is negative 3, because 27 is 3 times 9, which is 3 times 3. And the cube root of 64 is 4, so negative 3 fourths squared, which is negative 3 squared over negative 4 squared. Okay, we're going to write an equation of a line that passes through this point and is perpendicular to this line. So first I need to put this line into y equals mx plus b format so I can find the slope. So I'm going to move my 3x over to this side. It was positive, so now it's negative. And this y is negative. I don't want a negative y. So I'm going to divide everything by negative 1, or essentially change all the signs. My slope is 3. my perpendicular slope is going to be the reciprocal of 1/3. Next, I use my point -2, -3. Y is -3. X is 2 plus B. So I get -3 is equal to 2/3 plus B. Subtract 2/3 from both sides. 3 is -9/3 minus 2/3. So B is -11/3. So my equation then, I want to plug in my slope. Plug in my B. I'm going to solve and then graph. I have to graph this in order to solve it. So first, I need some graph paper. Next, I need to put my equation into y equals mx plus b format. So, I'm going to move my 4x over, it becomes negative, then I divide everything by 2, so I'm left with y is less than or equal to -2x plus 5. 5 is my y-intercept, and my slope is -2, so I go down 2 over 1. And you don't need to make this many points, it's just easier for me to draw my line this way. Now, because I'm less than or equal to, this indicates a solid line. If it was just less than, it would be a dashed line. But since it's not, I'll do a solid line. My solid line, and now I need to shade greater, less than or equal to, so one of these sides. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick a point that is not on the line. I'm going to pick 0, 0. If I plug that in, I get 0 is less than or equal to -2 × 0 + 5, or 0 is less than or equal to 5. This is true, so I'm going to shade this side. Every point on this side of the line would satisfy the inequality. Okay, in order to simplify, I'm going to plug in my square roots, distribute my square root. Square root of 3 times the square root of 3 is 3. Square root of 3 times the square root of 8 is the square root of 24. Now 24 is 4 times 6, and 4 is a perfect square. So I can take the square root of 4, which is 2. So I get 3 plus 2 times the square root of 6. Here I have the cube root of 6 over y. I need to separate that. Now I can't have radicals in the denominator, so in order to clear the cube root of y, I need to make this a perfect cube. In order to make that a perfect cube, I multiply by the cube root of y squared, because y times y squared will give me y to the third. So when I multiply this, I get the cube root of 6y squared over y. In order to solve this, I need to find the common denominator. In order to find the common denominator, I need to factor my quadratic. I'm going to go ahead and factor my numerator too, just to be on the safe side. And I get x minus 2 times x plus 1. As you can see here, these match these. So I need to multiply this times x plus 1 over x plus 1. And this times x minus 2 over x minus 2. Distribute, and I get 4x plus 4 over x squared minus x minus 2 plus 3x minus 6 over x squared minus x minus 2 is equal to, I'll go ahead and put that back in for now, 3x plus 3, x squared minus x minus 2. The reason I put that back in is if I have all common denominators, my numerators will be equal. So now I have 7x minus 2 is equal to 3x plus 3. Subtract 3x from both sides. I get 4x minus 2 is equal to 3. Add 2 to both sides. 4x is equal to 5. Divide by 4. X is equal to 5/4. To solve this, I'm going to need to clear this 2/3. A good way to clear a fraction is to multiply the entire equation or inequality by the denominator. The 3's over here will cancel, leaving me 2 times 9 minus x is less than or equal to 15. And I can distribute my 2. Subtract 18 from both sides, and I get negative 2x is less than or equal to negative 3. Divide by negative 2. Because I divided by negative, my inequality flips, and I have x is greater than or equal to 3/2. Domain and range. Domain is all possible x's, and range is all possible y's. Now these are going to go on forever, and as they go on forever, they're slowly going to move outwards. So that covers my x range. There are no x's that I cannot plug in. So my domain is x such that x is an element of the real numbers, so any number. Or you could say infinity, negative infinity to infinity. My range is all of my y's. As you can see, this will continue to move down. My upper limit on my range is this line right here. I'll never go above here. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So my range is either y such that y is less than or equal to 5, or I could say negative infinity to 5 and includes 5. To solve a system of equations, I need to either clear the x's or clear the y's. Here, if I multiply by 2, I'll get 6 and negative 6. So I'm going to multiply this equation by 2, which will give me a new system. 4x minus 6y is equal to 20. 4x plus 6y is equal to 4. I'll add those together, and I get 8x is equal to 24. Divide by 8, and x is equal to 3. Now I need to find y. I could go back to one of my original equations, plug in my x. 6 minus 3y is equal to 10. So subtract 6 from both sides, 3y, negative 3y is equal to 4, divide by negative 3, y is equal to negative 4/3. Okay, in order to solve a quadratic, I can use quadratic formula, completing the square, or factoring. I'm looking at factors of 7 with a difference of 3. That doesn't exist. Factors of 7 are only 7 and 1. I can't factor this. I don't want to complete the square because this is an odd number. Completing the square is best when you have an even number. So I'm going to use the quadratic formula. So here's my quadratic formula, keeping in mind that this invisible 1 is A, that's B, that's C. So negative B plus or minus the square root of B squared minus 4 times A times C over 2 times A. So that gives me negative 3 plus or minus the square root of 9 plus 28 over 2. So that's negative 3 plus or minus the square root of 37 over 2. 37 doesn't have any factors that I can pull out. There's no perfect squares. So this is my final answer. Here I'm going to use my square root property. I have two perfect squares, so I'm going to take the square of both sides. And I will get x plus 3 is equal to plus or minus 9. Because positive 9 squared is 81 and negative 9 squared is 81. I'm going to subtract 3 from both sides, so I get x is equal to negative 3 plus or minus 9. Negative 3 plus 9 is 6. Negative 3 minus 9 is negative 12. Okay, a person has 37 pennies and nickels. If they have 85 cents, how many nickels do they have? Okay, so I have pennies and nickels is equal to 37. I have 5 cents times my nickels plus 1 cent. Sorry, there should be a zero there. Times my pennies is equal to 0.85. I don't want to deal with decimals, so I'm going to multiply this whole thing by 100. And I get 5n plus p is equal to 85. If I bring this into terms of p, I get p is equal to 37 minus n. Now I can take this and plug it in to here. So I get 5n plus 37 minus n is equal to 85, or 4n is equal to, plus 37 is equal to 85. Subtract 37 from both sides. 4n is equal to 48, divide by 4, and you get n is equal to 12, so there are 12 nickels. In order to solve a problem like this, we're going to square both sides to clear the radical, which will give me 4x minus 1 is equal to, this is the same as this. So you can either FOIL it, or you can use your square trinomial rule, which is if this was A and this was B, you'd have A squared plus 2AB plus B squared. Now I need to set this equal to 0 in order to solve it. So I'm going to subtract 4x from both sides, and I'm going to add 1 to both sides. So I'm going to end up with x squared plus 2x plus 10 is equal to 0. Now I can't factor this. There are no factors of 10 that are equal to 2x. But I do have an even here, so I could complete the square, which means I'm going to move that 10 back over. I'm going to take 1 half of 2, which is 1, and then I'm going to square that, which is 1. So I'm going to add 1 to both sides. And what I'll get is x plus 1 squared is equal to negative 9. And I'll take the square root of both sides. And I get x plus 1 is equal to the square root of negative 9. The square root of negative 9 is 3 plus or minus 3i. I for the negative. Subtract 1 from each side and I get negative 1 plus or minus 3i. So that's negative 1 plus 3i and negative 1 minus 3i. Okay, in order to solve an absolute value inequality, this could be plus 5 and it would give me 5, or this could be negative 5 and it would give me 5. So I take this and I basically just remove the absolute value sign. Then I flip the inequality and negate the answer. Then I solve them each individually. So add 1 to each side, divide by 2, I get x is less than 6. Add 1 to both sides, divide by 2, and I get x is greater than negative 2. Now I want to graph this. Here's my 6, here's my negative 2. They're open circles because they're just less than. Less than 6 is this way, greater than negative 2 is this way, so I shade the portion in the center. Okay, to find slope and y-intercept, I need to put this into y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. So first I'm going to move 7x over, so I get negative 2y is equal to negative 7x plus 10. I'm going to divide everything by negative 2 to get y is equal to a negative over a negative is positive, 7 halves x minus 5. My y-intercept is negative 5. My slope is 7 halves. And that completes our final exam review. I know I went through it quickly, but hopefully you can follow it.